Turning back to the pandemic and the governor's decision to end indoor dining as COVID cases increase. According to the state, the restaurants and bars are the second most common places. Those with COVID tell contract tracers they've been within 14 days, Micah, of a positive test.
Yeah, we wanted to know more about the risk factor for eating inside along with other activities. So we asked Dr. Benjamin Singer to join us. He's an assistant professor at Northwestern University, Feinberg School of Music. Dr. Singer, thank you so much.
Hi, thank you for having me.
So when the tests, the positive tests go up, the first places to close down are the restaurants. A lot of restaurant owners say it's not fair. You're picking on us. Why not other places? Why not hair salons or grocery stores or, you know, ma and pa stores? There's so many stores and everything stays open, but the restaurants close first. Why is that? Are they being unfair or is there a reason for that?
Yeah, part of it is the epidemiology, the data you just showed, looking at contact tracing implicating being in a restaurant or a bar. And if you think about what happens inside a restaurant, you're in close proximity to one another. People obviously take their masks off to eat. And when you eat, you might clear your throat or cough more. And these are ways that the virus can spread more easily within a confined space.
Well, Dr. Singer, let's put forth what, you know, for one, the Illinois Restaurant Association has said, you know, their members really take extreme care and feel that they are mitigating it in an effective way, whether it's spacing, whether it's the outdoor dining or the, you know, the dining cubes that are set up outside. Do you think that that is still insufficient or simply not enough to protect people who would visit these institutions?
Yeah, outdoor dining certainly is not risk-free, but I think the increased airflow, the circulation of being outside in a restaurant setting really helps decrease the risk. And so I think outside is certainly preferable to inside when it comes to risk.
They say a lot of risks now are within your own family, within your close space, especially now during these colder months, and the holidays are coming up. So how isn't that just as bad as being in a restaurant?
Yeah, it's a different topic, but certainly people within a shared environment within a house are at very high risk to spread COVID-19 if one of the people in the house, if a family member is infected.
What do you mean it's a different topic?
Because people with you know within their house, they're obviously much closer for a much longer period of time than they might be within a restaurant.
So I would think that would be harder then.
Well, that's right, but there are also fewer people coming through any given house more likely than a restaurant, right? So, you know, if you even have a number of people in your house, maybe, you know, 5-10 people come through your house, whereas a restaurant, it could be hundreds.
I see.
I'll ask you to project out, if you could, Doctor. We're looking at these increased restrictions coming back here and lasting for a couple of weeks. Do you think that will be enough to make some serious progress that will allow these restaurants and bars to be able to reopen again in whatever fashion they're able to do that?
I certainly hope so. Generally, what we have seen is that there's, at the earliest, about a two-week lag between when social distancing and other mitigation measures like closing indoor dining go into effect and when we start to see the effect on case numbers. And so that I hope that within a few weeks we'll know the effect of this and can make plans going forward.
We're all knocking on wood. Dr. Benjamin Singer, nice to talk to you. Thanks for the time this afternoon.
My pleasure. Thank you.